So let's talk about how to calculate continuously compounded interest. Here's an example where we're told that there was a deposit of $1,023 at 7.8% interest, compounded continuously over 4 years, and we're asked to find the earned interest. Anytime we have continuously compounded interest, we're going to use the formula capital A equals capital P e to the rt. P is going to be our principal, which is the amount that we start with in our account. And A is going to be our ending balance, or the amount that we end with in the account. A is actually going to include the earned interest as well as the original principal. So A is equal to the principal plus the earned interest. We're going to end up using both of these relationships. R is always going to be your interest rate in decimal form. It's important to convert that percentage form into decimal form. And T is always going to be the amount of time in years. So if they give it to you in months, for example, you're going to convert that to a fraction of a year. All right, so in this case, we know that P is equal to $1,023. That's how much we start with in the account. Now, you might be wondering what E is. E is approximately 2.71. E is like the number pi. It's an irrational number. It's a constant. We can't write it completely because irrational numbers have decimals that go on forever without repeating. So we call it E. And then R, in this case, we're going to write as 0.078. Remember, to convert 7.8% to decimal, we just move that decimal place to the left two places. That's the same as dividing by 100. And percent means per 100. And then time t is equal to 4. So we're going to plug in, and we have A is equal to 1023. Remember, if there's a number in front of a variable, or in this case the constant letter E, that's implying multiplication. Don't always write it, but it's there. E to the RT, so that's going to be E to the power of 0.078 times 4. I'm going to put that in parentheses just to emphasize that that operation has to occur before we do what's called exponentiating, raising E to that power. So a good deal of the work in this problem is going to be plugging into our calculator and doing that in a correct way so that the calculator understands the correct order of operations. So looking at our calculator, I'm going to use the TI30XIIS. Remember that our order of operations tells us that we have to do what's in any grouping symbols first. When we have an exponent with an operation in it, essentially that operation's been grouped. Okay, so we have our parentheses, our grouping symbols first. That's our P in the order of operations. E is exponents. M, D, which we have to remember is the same step, is multiplication and division. And then AS, addition and subtraction, gives us our PEMDAS, or please excuse my dear Aunt Sally. So we're going to start with the multiplication and the exponent first. Then we're actually going to raise the e to that power second. And then we're going to multiply by 1023 third. So I'm going to do this manually, meaning that I'm not going to ask my calculator to do it. I'm going to show you how to do it step by step. And then we'll do it where we plug the whole thing in and the proper way so that our calculator can do the order of operations itself. All right, so here we go. The first way, turning on my calculator, I'm going to start by plugging in 0.078 and multiplying that by the number 4 and hitting equals to give me the exponent. Important thing, especially when we're dealing with money, we don't want to make any, even the tiniest errors will lose us money. So what we want to do is never round off until the very last step. I'm going to not clear that out and retype it. That's going to make my answer as exact as possible. I want to raise e to that power. The number e is associated with the natural log, which is a button up here on the left side of the calculator. So you see above the natural log ln, you see e to the x. So the next thing we'd like to do is to raise e to that power. So I'm going to hit second, and then I'm going to hit e to the x. And now you might notice, oh no, you know, that number went away and I need that number. That's okay, because our calculators these days pretty much all have an ANS function down at the bottom here. You see it above the negative, and that ANS has stored the answer to the previous calculation. So I'm going to say second ANS, okay, close my parentheses, equals. And so what we just found was e to that power is 1.36 and so on. Notice that it's a value greater than 1. Okay, because if we return exactly 1 times the principal, we're going to get just the principal. We want something a little bit bigger than that, at least. So 1.36, that seems reasonable. So I'm going to multiply that now times the principal. The principal was the coefficient of e. 1023 equals, a equals 1,397.58 rounded to the nearest cent. Now remember, that's the total amount in the account at the end of the 4 years, but we were not asked that. We were asked for the earned interest. A is the sum of the principal plus the earned interest. Or another way of saying that is the earned interest that we're looking for, I, is going to be A minus the original principal. So in order to find our answer, we need 1397.58, and we need to subtract from that what we started with, which was 1023. So 1397.58 minus 1023 gives us $374.58. So our earned interest is $374.58. Now, just to show you that there is another way to enter this into our calculators, let's go back and clear this out. And now I'm going to enter it in such a way that my calculator gets the right order of operations all on its own. 1023 times second natural log button, which has the e to the power of x above it. And you see the e to the, and it already puts parentheses for us. And we're going to put 0.078 times 4, close the parentheses, equals. And here we see our $1,397.58 again. So I hope this video was helpful to you. If it was, please remember to like the video down below. And remember, I take requests, so all you have to do is post a comment at the bottom if there is a follow-up question or another topic you'd like to see a video about.